Crosby and the Pens taking on the Bruins tonight. For more on that, we say hello to Jason Mackey of the Pittsburgh Post-Gazette. Jason, I'm just going to put this as simply as I can. What's up with Evgeni Malkin?
Jackie, you're not the first person to wonder that question. It's been kind of curious, and there are some numbers that will probably flash on your screen soon that aren't great. One even strength goal in his past 20 games, minus 15 during that stretch. You know, Evgeni Malkin started out as hot as any player in the NHL over the first 10 games of the season, and, you know, the talk was sky high. But since then, it just hasn't been great. He's taken a lot of bad penalties, usually in the offensive zone, usually late in games. He's been frustrated. He's been with Phil Kessel. He's been away from Phil Kessel. Now he's back with Phil Kessel. He's going to have a new left wing with Zach Aston-Reese. You know, I guess you could say that replacing Carl Hagelin's been an issue. But one of the things, Mike Sullivan talked about this morning, they're working with Evgeni Malkin on, is simply simplifying his game, shooting. Don't look for the next play. Just get the puck on net. And so, you know, I think, I don't want to say confidence is an issue, but just sort of, you know, snapping out of it, not thinking as much. I think that's something. And you know, we all know with Evgeni Malkin, this could change at the drop of a hat, too. I'll be interested to see what happens tonight.
Yeah, not the first time that a player has had to simplify their game to break out of a little bit of a slump. But the Penguins recently losing Hornqvist to an upper body injury. What's the latest on when he could return, and how has his absence affected this team?
Yeah, so Patric Hornqvist is technically day-to-day, but the Penguins have a lot of games in December. I think a lot of people have a lot of games in December, and the lack of practice time could hurt him. They're back-to-back tonight against Boston and in L.A. They're off Sunday. They play Monday. He's been out of the lineup enough and has practiced so little that he's probably going to need some time to get back. You know, I'm not looking for him to play tomorrow. I think Monday might be a stretch, and without him, it's been really tough. I mean, they're in a tough spot. You heard Sidney Crosby and Chris Letang talking about it, just needing points. He's their emotional leader. He's their heartbeat. This guy is crazy. You know, I mean that in a good way. He's just so intense, and especially on the power play too. They just haven't found an answer to replace him in front of the net. They're trying Jake Guentzel there, but they just don't have another guy who does what he does as well as he does it, and they need to find somebody to go to the front of the net on the top power play and pick up some of that trash the way Hornqvist did with Crosby, Malkin, and everybody else.
You mentioned Hagelin earlier in this conversation. We all know Jimmy Rutherford is or can be aggressive on the trade market. Where does he stand on trades, and do you expect anything else to happen?
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't say it's imminent, but we all know Jim Rutherford. He is not one to stand pat. He's very active, probably the most active general manager in the NHL. And where he's at right now is watching a couple different things. I think it's easy to say they need a defenseman, and I'm not so sure that's the most obvious direction here. You know, this team needs to be better defensively, but it doesn't mean it needs to get a defenseman. I think they're watching the situation with Derek Brassard. He'll be back at third line center tonight against the Bruins. And I think they're watching this sort of figure out, is this guy fit? Is he the right player for this team? And I genuinely think that Jim is up in the air on it. And so if they determine he's not, which easily could happen, I could see him trying to go out and get a third line center, somebody that fits the way Nick Bonino did and not necessarily Derek Brassard did. And you still look on defense. Maybe they want to get a little bit better there. But I do expect Jim, if this continues, to do something. His mandate is to win now, to get in the playoffs, to compete for the Stanley Cup. It's simply not good enough to sort of be sputtering the way they have.
Yeah, we all know he's not afraid to make a deal. The question is finding one that he likes. One more for you, Jason, before we let you go. We like to include our viewers on this show. So this question comes from a Penguins fan on Twitter. Have the Pens lost their speed demon identity? Your thoughts?
I don't think they've lost their identity, but I do understand, and we get this a lot in Pittsburgh, are the Penguins slow? I think there's some merit to saying the rest of the league has caught up, but I think the Penguins haven't done themselves any favors so far in how they play. They've had trouble getting out of their zone at times, whether that's poor passes in their own zone or just their breakouts, stuff along the wall. I don't think they've lost their identity, but I do think it has been challenged, and I think other parts of their game have made it so there's a much more thin or much thinner margin for error. So, no, they haven't lost their identity. It's just been threatened a little bit.
Very well said, Jason. Thank you for this. Always a pleasure. Penguins taking on the Bruins tonight.
Thank you.